In today's tutorial, we're going to guide you through the process of creating a new lifecycle with the Teams Manager app. Begin by launching the Teams Manager and accessing the Settings menu. Within the Governance section, select Lifecycle Management. This section provides an overview of existing lifecycles. To initiate a new lifecycle, click on Add Lifecycle. Start by assigning a name and a description to your lifecycle. This is for your own reference, so choose a name and description that you can identify. The next step involves deciding on the calculation type for your lifecycle. The system defaults to using the Teams creation date. However, if metadata fields are available, you have the flexibility to use these as the basis for your calculation date. You also have the option to select activity as a calculation type. This means a team is considered inactive based on the lack of channel messages, reactions, and organized meetings over a selected period. To enable this option, it's necessary to disable concealing reports in the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. For detailed instructions on this, please refer to our blog, which is linked in the description box below. Following this, you need to decide if the lifecycle can be extended by the team owner. If enabled, team owners can prolong the lifecycle through a chat notification. If this feature is not activated, team owners will be notified about the impending archiving but will not have the ability to prevent it. Proceed to the Notification tab, where you'll set the notification period before the archiving date to inform team owners of the upcoming archiving. In the Archive tab, specify the duration a team exists before it is archived. It's important to note that the archiving process applies only to teams. Yammer communities, SharePoint sites, and planner contents will receive notifications but will not be archived. Communication sites and modern sites without a group will not receive notifications. For enterprise customers, there's an option to set SharePoint sites to read only. Consider the option to automatically delete teams after archiving. Here you can determine the period a team remains post-archiving before it's deleted. Remember, teams are permanently deleted after 30 days from deletion, so use this feature with caution. Once all settings are configured, click Create to establish your lifecycle. To implement the lifecycle, you will need to create a policy package and an execution policy as subsequent steps. For additional information on how Teams Manager can assist your organization, we invite you to book a free demo with our governance experts through our website.